Since when I was a kid, I was a cycling enthusiast. Every time I ride my cycle, I'll be in a different world, putting my headphones or earphones on, listening to a podcast episode or listening to music and riding, thinking about the thoughts coming in and out, watching the outdoors in a slow pace is truly incredible. And this episode is related to that. So let's not wait anymore. Get into the episode because this is my cycling story. Whenever my mom used to ask me to get something from a grocery shop, I always used to get my cycle and go there and take up all the groceries. And while coming back, I used to forget the cycle and come back, and my mom used to scold me and go get the cycle, and I used to go back and get it back. I used to ride my cycle everywhere and anywhere that I went. And we Indians have a ritual, especially South Indians, we have a ritual during Dasara times. We do puja for all the vehicles. I was so excited when that festival comes because I could decorate my cycle with fancy stuff, with flowers, with ribbons, and I had a very small cycle, and I used to travel everywhere. I used to enjoy riding that cycle. And after that, I grew up and I purchased another bicycle, and it was good. I kept it for about 2 years or so, but I lost that cycle. Someone took it away, and that was it. After a month or so, my parents got me another cycle. I just ride it for another 6 months or so, and then things got changed. I was introduced to the whole two-wheeler petrol bike thing, and that took away my cycling journey or cycling relationship, and attachment towards cycling started drifting away, and then it was gone. I never took a ride. And it was like vanished. So this was my backstory. A year back, I was going through Instagram and I saw a couple of posts regarding cycling, and I was intrigued for a bit. I remembered all the memories that I used to have with cycling, and that seed of wanting to get back to cycling began. We went to the Decathlon. And we saw people purchasing cycles, and the cycles were good, but it was of heavy price also, and I didn't want to invest in that amount of money. I wasn't sure that whether I was gonna continue cycling, so I hesitated to get a new cycle. So I decided not to purchase a new one. I went back to my old cycle, got it repaired, and started cycling. Now, it's been a year. I've been cycling almost every day without fail, even though I skip a day or two. After getting back to cycling, I remind myself how much I have missed the journey with cycling. I remind myself the bonding that I used to have towards cycling or towards cycle. Whenever I ride my cycle, I wear a pair of earphones and listen to a podcast or music and just simply ride. And I look at the outdoors, I enjoy the outdoors, and I love to explore places. And especially being in a city like Bangalore, you don't get the calmness because everywhere you see horns and you see people, ambience, and you see factories. But I have a mini forest nearby. Every day when I take my cycle out, I go towards there. It is outskirts of Bangalore. I ride there, and it's calm place. You can hear birds making sounds. You can hear the calmness. Even though there are vehicles moving here and there, but it's not much. It's like you're going in a highway road. And I get to see sunsets and sunrises. Those are beautiful. And sometimes I get to see peacocks. The first time that I saw a peacock was like, wow, I'm in a Bangalore and I get to see a peacock. And I get to listen to a lot of music, and I get time to listen to podcasts. The slow pace of cycling, the slow pace of exploring things around you, watching everywhere, pedaling, that calmness, that slow pedaling, it feels good. And watching road, watching you moving slowly, it's a wonderful feeling that I am just experiencing and just love experiencing it. And I'm so happy that I got back to cycling. And if you plan on getting into cycling, you must. If you are feeling stressed, if you are feeling too much, I think you can develop the habit of cycling. And trust me, I have cut down my weight a lot, and I had a huge thighs, and now it's like this. So yeah, my thigh fat has reduced, my total fat has been reduced, and it put me in a better physical health and also mental health. More than physical health, the reason that I cycle is for my mental health. It keeps my mind calm, it keeps my mind composed, it keeps my mind relaxed, and I get some clarity when I cycle. And that is one of the key reasons that I cycle every day. So get back to cycling. I'm damn sure that you will have a wonderful, amazing journey and a beautiful habit that you can cultivate in your life. And you need not get a new cycle. If you don't have a bicycle, rent a bicycle for a week or so. It will take a couple of days to get used to it. You'll get some body pain, but it will be for a while and it will go off. Try it out. And if you have an old cycle or lying down, just don't go for a new cycle. Get it repaired, get it serviced, and you don't need another cycle. If you go and purchase because you want a cycle, think that's not a good idea. If you are really interested, you will know when you need to get one. So this was my cycling story. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you liked my journey. If you think this episode was good, and if you think you enjoyed my story, and if you think that my episodes, my videos, my content is good, then please do share it with one single person that you feel they need it the most. So that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I hope you learned something new out of this episode, and I hope you enjoyed my cycling story. I will see you in the next episode. Until then, bye-bye. Take care. You are listening to the Personal Growth Podcast, Life Itself, and I'm your host, Dhimu Bhardwaj. See you in the next episode.